Hi everyone, Samantha here from the Alice Ferguson Foundation, and today is a beautiful rainy day, which means it's a perfect day for an at-home experiment. Today, we're going to make bioplastics. Now, bioplastics are usually made from different types of plants, such as corn, soy, and even seaweed. Our normal plastics that we use throughout our day-to-day life are made from petroleum, also known as crude oil. But today's plastic is going to be made from milk. That's right, milk. And today we only need to use two ingredients for this to happen. So let's head into the kitchen and see how this thing works. For today's experiment, we are going to need a pot to warm up the milk, a spoon to stir. This will be our strainer for when we need to separate it. You're going to want a towel to remove excess moisture. And then a little shape or cookie cutter of your choice to shape the plastic when it's time. And then last but certainly not least, our ingredients. So I have 4 tablespoons of white vinegar and then 1 cup of milk. Now it's time to warm up our 1 cup of milk. So I'm going to pour that in here. And we are going to heat it up to about hot chocolate temperature, so about 130 degrees. When our milk has reached 130 degrees or to the point where it's a little hot to touch, you are going to add our 4 tablespoons of vinegar. Let the magic begin. You start stirring it. You notice it starts to separate. Ugh, gross, but awesome all at the same time. Now it's time to strain it. Nice. And pat it down, get some of the excess moisture out of there. And you can see it's nice and chunky. I just scooped it out of the strainer. Just wait until it cools down a bit. Now I'm gonna pat it down to get all that excess moisture out of it. Once you're done patting it, it should look like this. And now it's time to add it to our little cookie cutter. Here sits our future bioplastic made from milk. Now I've been doing a few experiments on these different things to see how long it takes for them to harden. A couple of days ago I made one, and this is what it looks like after 2 days of just sitting in my house. This piece here I had sitting in the sun. It's a little harder than the one that I used in the house, but that was just for 1 day. My next experiment was baking them. So this was baked at 200 degrees for 15 minutes, and you can hear the difference. You got a little cooked right there though. And this I baked at 175 for 30 minutes. You can hear the difference. All I know is that after this is done, I'm gonna try a different experiment to see how long this will take to break down in our environment. If not disposed of or composted properly, bioplastics can still cause harm to our wildlife and environment. We need to be mindful about the things that we purchase and try avoiding single-use items, whether they're bioplastic or not. If possible, remember to BYOC, bring your own container. And if you're unable to bring your own container, try to research fun alternatives that you can use to help reduce your waste at home. Stay tuned to hear about the bioplastics that I created. What's going to happen to them? Will they compost? How long will it take for them to break down? And will they mold?